Through lots of corks to be able to produce these flutes. And of course, I end up with a lot of donations. Corks like this won't work. It takes too much time to trim these kind of corks. So I really do need a cork that right into the flute without hardly any trimming. So we'll take one of these wine corks, which is a Rancho Ventavo cork right here, which fit perfectly into the flutes. They need to be snug enough to fit, and it just so happens that this particular winery makes the perfect size cork that I don't have to trim it. It fits in nice and snug. I do have to trim the angle into the cork, which I'll do right now. Bring it down here, and this is a bit of a trick I've learned. You just take a slight little edge off the top and make a cut down to about the midway in the cork. And here's how this goes. It barely takes the edge off. Straight down and off. Trim it, a little excess off, and now I have my trimmed cork. The wind will, when we blow, will go in, hit the slope, go up the slope like a little ski jump, and that will in turn hit the edge. Once I push it in, hit right up to the edge of that hole, of the fipple or whistle hole. So now I'll go ahead and fit that cork in nice and snug. It comes in just to where the top of the hole is. The cork will come right up to that spot, and that's the sweet spot right there. That's the magic spot, which really makes it play. One other trick I found was to take a piece of sandpaper and slightly smooth this edge so the air will roll off it a little bit better, only about 4 or 5 hits with the sandpaper, so there's just a ever so slight rolling of that angle. Now we're ready to place it. I'll go ahead, push that cork in. It has to be perfectly straight, can't be turned or bent. And once I get it started, it fits right in. I take my dowel to complete pushing it in, it works its way in, and I went a little too far, which is normal. So now I go in with my, with my screwdriver, and I will push that cork back into place where it's just perfectly level right in there. You can barely see that, where the cork has come right up to the edge of that hole. That's the magic spot. So now I take my screwdriver, trick number three that I've learned, to open up that passageway just a little bit more, by pushing down, making that passageway open up a little on the cork. And now we try it. I can test it without ever touching the mouthpiece, which I do to the student flutes, by making a mouthpiece with my hand. And we get the sound. But I'll go ahead and try this one for real.